the project of Chimp Eden could have been almost any animal. I think it was the mere case of opportunity that I bumped into someone that worked for the Jane Goodall Institute. They told me about their problems, and that escalated because I said to him, listen, why don't you come have a look at our facility, and perhaps we can build something here that the chimps, you know, could learn to love.
Sanctuary is on commercial property. There is a lodge and a restaurant that is run by having the backup of a commercial entity running and actually funding your chimps. It means that these guys actually have a secure home to stay in.
Here at Chimp Eden, we don't actually have so much hands-on with the animals, so it's very hands-off rehabilitation. I am one of the ones that holds the permit to touch the chimps. Really, the only reason that we do this kind of thing is that when they're sick, they will come to us for medication and so on. If they're never handled at all by people, why would they come when they're sick? Because if you give them a scratch every morning or so, they're quite used to coming to you. So then it's much easier to medicate them.
Because we're in the business of rescuing chimps, we can't really afford to breed chimps at the sanctuary. For every chimp that is bred here means one less space to rescue a chimp. So this is why we've taken the decision, or the decision has been taken, to contracept the breeding.
These animals are in dire straits, and as such, that they need protection. And if they can't be protected in their countries of origin, at least we can protect them here. We realize this is not Central Africa. It's not all the rainforest and stuff here. But the chimps are well looked after, and they have a freedom to associate with their mates and become chimps again.